I know when we hear the word bullying, we think of kids, children, running in the playground and being messed with, but that's not always true. So here I am to bring some truth to the light. Five places bullying needs to stop. Five. Number one, the workplace. Now, when you are at home and you wake up and you go get dressed to go to your job, you never think in your head, I gotta go somewhere where my boss is a bully. Well, I gotta go somewhere where my boss gonna make me work extra. My boss gonna make me do tasks that ain't even my job. My boss is going to bother me and he gonna hide it or she gonna hide it under the guise of it's my job. Workplace bullying is the absolute worst. Why? Because that person knows that you need to make money to provide for your family and have a livelihood. And they take their little bit of egos, they take their little balls, their little cojones, their little labia lips, and they take advantage of you because they couldn't do it in the real world. So they try to force themselves upon you at the workplace. Hey, Josh, I need you to move these boxes, but I don't even touch boxes. You gonna move these boxes or you gonna lose your job. Hey, Sarah, I need you to serve food in the cafeteria better. But I work in human resources. I don't even work in the cafeteria. You gonna serve this food better or you gonna lose your job. Workplace bullying happens way too often and people get away with it way too much. If you see somebody that's getting taken advantage of at their job and you choose to say nothing, your silence can be your agreeance. Number two, online. I think it's a special place in the opposite of heaven for people that sit online and bully people behind a keyboard. I don't understand it. I'll never get it. Somebody can post a picture of their puppy. Your dog is so ugly. Somebody can say the sky is blue. The sky is orange. You're ugly. Somebody can post a picture of their child. Your child is hideous. Your child is ugly. For those people that wake up every single morning, get online and say, you know what? I'm just going to say really mean things. I hope your bottled water tastes like whale sink water. I hope your pH balance is thrown off for the next five generations. And I hope your internet is slow as sucking peanut butter through a garden hose. Number three, your gym. Now, this is probably one of the most unthought of places where bullying happens. You ever go to the gym and you're working out and you're looking at a machine and you're gonna go use it, then somebody rudely comes, doesn't say, excuse me. They just walk right in front of you, sit down, put their stuff down around it, and look at you in your eye, and you don't want any confrontation because you're in the gym. Now, you've been in the gym for about 30 minutes. This person just walked in, so you know if you put your hand on this person, you can cave his whole chest in. You can end this whole world. But people in the gym who feel like they're bigger or they're more intimidating or they're more fit than you are, they take advantage of your kindness in a gym, whether it's the locker that you want, whether it's the machine that you want. You want to be on this treadmill, but that person comes to stand by that treadmill to make sure you can't use that treadmill. You go to the basketball court to play basketball, and then they just start running the pickup game. They don't ask you to get off the court nicely. Bullying happens in fitness centers all the time. And if you are a person and you see it happening, you probably want to intervene a little bit, or you can put the person that's trying to do the bullying on notice. Listen, that person was here first. I saw it. Calm down. We'll take our time, we'll take turns, we'll get everything done. Be patient. Number four, inside in-law relationships, meaning mother-in-law to daughter-in-law, father-in-law to son-in-law. When people get married, you get married into families. Now, a wife wants to get along with the mother to appease her husband. That mother knows that, and she takes advantage of the relationship with the daughter-in-law. So that mother might start asking the daughter-in-law to do unnecessary stuff, or that father-in-law might ask the son-in-law, hey, you want to go watch this game? Nah, Mr. Clark, I don't want to go. So you don't love my daughter. So you gonna disrespect her father, okay, Mr. Clark? And now the son-in-law doing things with the father-in-law that he don't wanna do just to make sure his marriage or his relationship with his spouse still work. If you are in a relationship where you know your spouse don't really vibe your mother or your father, you should step in and let it be known. It's not fair. I married you. I ain't married your mother. I ain't married your father. I ain't married your brother. I ain't married your sister. I ain't married your best friend. I'm not with that. They treat me a certain kind of way. If I gotta be treated like that just to stay with you, then me and you could pack up our stuff and we could separate. You can go make love to your family. You do the incest thing. I'll be fine over here by myself. Bullying needs to stop happening in in-law relationships. I'm gonna get a shirt that say it. And number five, your faith-based family. Now, I am a Christian man and I love the Lord. And my relationship with God, to me, is personal. I talk to him every day, I pray every day, but my relationship with the Lord is personal and it's private, although I don't have a problem publicly professing my love for the Lord. Try to say that three times fast. In my faith, the Bible is the guideline, but people will get into your faith and try to change the things you do to fit the things they do. If they're doing something and you're having fun and you loving your life and they don't like it and they can't do it, they'll make you feel terrible for doing what you want to do, even though you're following the guidelines of your faith. Do not be bullied by the personal ideologies of your faith-based family, and you don't want to follow that person's personal belief, not faith belief, but personal belief, they will begin to bully you, and they'll make you feel some kind of way. They'll make you feel inadequate. They'll basically make you feel like you ain't going to that final place where you want to go home for eternity. Do not fall into the hole of being bullied because you think you are too old or because you think it cannot happen to you. It happens all the time, and do not be a person that stands by and watch it happen and say nothing about it when you can help fix it. My name is Josh Prey. This is Bullying PSA, and I hope everybody has learned something.